welcome you all to my channel. If this is your first time of coming to my channel, thanks a lot. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, like, share and subscribe. So in today's video, we are going to making a simple video on how to cut a monostripe dress with pleating, and I'm going to be explaining how to know the number of inches required for you in order for you to pleat a dress. And we are also going to discuss how to achieve our monostripe dress with a form of bustier, right? So we have a bustier, we have our monostripe effect, and we also have our pleating in this video. So don't forget to stay tuned. Feel free to drop your questions or your comments below, and you can join us on Facebook Tilly Designs and on Instagram Tilly Designs. All the details are going to be in the description box below. So what are the basic measurements required? Our shoulder measurements, bust measurements, waist, hip and our gown length. And also, we also need our half length. Now, for you to know the number of inches required for your half length, it simply means from your shoulder to 1 inch above your navel. So for your half length, it simply means from your shoulder to 1 inch above your navel. So you can go ahead and measure that in order for you to know your half length, right? So our shoulder measurement is 14. We have 14 divided by 2, we have 7. Our bust is 36. 36 plus 2 divided by 4 plus 1, we have 10.5. Our waist is 28. 28 plus 2 divided by 4 plus 2, we have 9.5. Our hip is 38. 38 plus 2 divided by 4 plus 1, we have 11 inches. Now, our gown length is 33 inches. What this 33 inches simply means is from our shoulder to where we desire our gown length to get up to. And that's why we have 33 inches. Now, for shoulder to half length simply means from your shoulder to 1 inch above your navel. And for that, we have 16 inches, right? So, in order for you to calculate your gown length, go ahead and deduct your half length from it. Now, your half length is where we are going to have the monostripe effect, and from our half length to our gown length is where we are going to have the pleating effect, and that's where we are going to calculate how many amounts of fabric is required in order for you to pleat a dress. So I will go ahead and deduct my half length from my gown length. So I have 33 minus 16, I have 17 inches. Now I will go ahead and add my sewing allowance, 2 inches for my hemming allowance, because I'm going to make use of half inch to attach it to my half length, and the other 1.5 for my hemming allowance. So I will go ahead and add 2 inches, I have 19 inches. So it simply means that for the length of our pleating, we are going to be making use of 19 inches for the length, right? Now, from shoulder to half length, we have 16 inches. We'll go ahead and just add 1 inch for our sewing allowance, because we are going to attach our pleating to it. So we just have plus 1, we have 17 inches. Now, in order for you to know how many inches is required for you to achieve your pleating, you are going to be making use of your hip measurements, right? Go ahead and multiply your hip measurements by 3 or by 2.5. That is to know the amount of fabric required in order for you to pleat a dress. So if you want it to be very full, you go ahead and multiply your hip measurement by 3. But if you don't really want it to be that bulky, you multiply your hip measurement by 2.5. But in today's video, I'm going to be multiplying my hip measurement by 3. So my hip is 38. 38 times 3, I have 114 inches. So I'm going to be having 140 inches for the length, and I'm going to explain that in the course of this video. Now, if you find it very difficult for you to be able to measure your 114 inches, I advise you shop for our tape measure, which is above 60 inches. So we have a tape measure which I'm going to show you in the course of this video, which exceeds beyond 60 inches. This is not like your regular tape measure, right? So for such tape measure, it is very easy for you to achieve your 116 inches on a go, because it is beyond 60 inches. And guess what, guys? This tape measure is available at our store, and you can also join us for training. I'm going to put down the details below. Now, the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and draft my pattern before we move to the fabric. But note that for our pleating, we are not drafting pattern for our pleating, right? So you are only going to draft pattern for the upper bodies of this dress, where we have our monostripe effect and also how to achieve our bustier effect. And this is what we have. Pattern papers are available at our store. And one thing I love about this pattern paper is it's about 60 inches long. So I recommend every one of you to get this. And it is also available at our store. Guys, so the first thing we are going to do now is we are going to go ahead and mark our basic measurements. Now we have our shoulder to armhole. Our shoulder to armhole 9 inches. Our shoulder to bust 10 inches. Shoulder to under bust 13.5. Shoulder to waist we have 17 inches. So these are the basic lines. I will go ahead and connect that together. Shoulder to armhole 9 inches. Shoulder to armhole 9.5. Shoulder to bust 10 inches. Shoulder to under bust 13.5. Shoulder to waist 17 inches. I will go ahead with my pattern master, which is available, and connect the lines together. What I'm going to do now is to go ahead and mark that measurement. I'm going to make use of 4 inches for my dart. I'll go ahead and mark 4 inches. I'll mark 4 inches. I will go in with my pattern master and connect the lines together. Now, on the waistline, I will go ahead and mark 1/2 inch on both sides. I will connect it to my bust point. Now, because this is going to have a princess dart bustier, I'm going to go ahead and extend this dart line to my shoulder line this way. So this is what we have. On the shoulder line, I will go ahead and mark 5 inches. I will connect the 5 inches to the bust line. So this is what we are going to have. Now, on the under bust line, I will go ahead and mark 1/2 inch on the under bust line. I will go ahead and connect this together. Now we are going to make use of this inner part of our pattern master to connect it to the waist. So this is what we are going to have, right? This is what we are going to have. Now, the next thing we are going to do now is to go ahead and close our shoulder darts. Go ahead and close our shoulder darts. I'll tape this down. So it's very necessary for you to close it before you mark your shoulder measurement. Now, once I'm done with that, I will go ahead and mark my shoulder measurement. So for my shoulder measurement, I have 7 inches. I will go ahead and mark my shoulder measurement. Now, I'll mark my bust measurement, which is 10.115. I'll mark our waist measurement, which is 10 inches. I will go ahead with my pattern master and connect the bust to waist. I'll make use of the armhole curve to connect my armhole. going to be showing you guys how to achieve that. So you open up your shoulder darts. Open up your shoulder darts. Go ahead and mark what you have for your armhole. So our armhole, we have about 9 inches divided by 2. You have 4.5. Come down with half inch. You mark this point. Now, you are going to go ahead and connect your bust point to your... Connect this bust point to the armhole line. So I will go ahead with my pattern master and I will connect that together. This is what we are going to have. So you will discover that for you to just achieve your preset dart bustier, firstly, get your normal shoulder dart bustier. So for you to achieve your preset dart bustier, from your normal basic bustier, right, which is your shoulder bustier, you just go ahead and check what you have for your armhole, divide it by 2, come down with half inch, and then you connect it to your bust points, right, to where you have your bust line. So another thing you should also take note of is we are going to be adding to our pattern when we are transferring to the fabric. Okay, so we'll go ahead and cut this out. So in order for us to achieve our mono strap effect, we are going to go ahead and have our full front. Now in order for you to achieve your full front, there are two ways in which you can go about that. Firstly, is to trace out what you have here on this other part to give you your full front, or you can go ahead and mark it all over again. But for the sake of this video, because in case if you don't understand while we're cutting this part, I hope you understand it while we are dealing with this other part. So I'm going to go ahead and retake all the measurements again so that you can understand it better, okay? Now, the first thing we did was that we went ahead to mark our dart measurement, which is 4 inches. We marked our dart, which is 4 inches. Go ahead and connect the lines together. This is what you are going to have. On the waistline, mark half inch on both sides. Mark half inch on both sides. Connect it together. Now go ahead and extend this third dart line to your shoulder line. On your shoulder line, go ahead and mark 5 inches. Connect your 5 inches to your bust line. This is what we are going to have. On the under bust, go ahead and mark half inch on both sides. Half inch on both sides. Then you go ahead and connect it together. Now you are going to make use of this round part to connect it to your waistline. So I hope you understand this now. So this is just like our basic shoulder bustier, but because what we want to achieve is our preset dart bustier, we'll also go ahead and close our shoulder dart so that we can have our accurate armhole measurement. Part is going to pop out because of the bustier effect, okay? That shows you that your bustier is actually correct. So you can see this part will automatically puff out. So once you are done with that, you go ahead and take your shoulder measurement. Go ahead and mark my shoulder measurement. I'll mark my bust measurement, which is 10.75. I'll go ahead and mark my waist measurement. My waist measurement, which is 10 inches. I'll go in with my pattern master and connect the bust to waist. And I'll make use of our armhole curve, which is available at our store, and connect shoulder line. So this is what we have, right? Now, because what we want, so I've gone ahead to connect my armhole line, and I've also connected my butt line to my waistline, and this is what I have. Now, I'm going to go ahead and cut this out. Basically, this is what we have. You can see that we have our full front, which is like the full basic front, right? This is what we have, and we have our preset cut that effect. Now, on this other part, we are also going to achieve our preset that on this other part. Now, for you to have your preset that, our armhole is 9 inches divided by 2, you have 4.5. Come down with half inch so that you can have ease around the armhole. We have 5 inches. So, I will go ahead and connect it to this bust line. So, this is what we have, right? So, this is our full front. I'm going to go ahead and tape this down together. Tape this down and we have our full front. Now, what we are going to do now is to go ahead and mark our neckline. And another thing you also have to do is determine where you want your monostrap to fall, either on this part or on this part. Note that it is optional, okay? So yours can fall at the right hand or at the left hand. It totally depends on what you want to achieve at the end of the day. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go ahead and mark my neckline.
So the next thing we are going to do now is we are going to go ahead and mark our neckline starting from the center front. So I will go ahead and mark 3 inches for my neckline. So once I'm done with that, I marked it on one side. You also determine where you want your monostripe to fall and where you want your normal shoulder to be. Note the deepness of my neckline, which I made use of 5 inches, and I will go ahead and connect my neckline to my armhole line. Okay, I will go ahead and connect my neckline to my armhole line. So we've determined that we want that part to be our normal shoulder and the other part to be our monostripe. So I'll go ahead using my pattern master and I'll connect the neckline to my shoulder line this way. So once I'm done with that, this is what I'm going to have. You can see the slant, and the neckline just helps us to know where to slant it up to. So I'll go ahead and cut this out. After cutting it out, we'll go ahead and cut out our bustier effect and our princess dart effect. We'll go ahead and cut that out. So once we are done, this is what we are going to have. We have 2 pieces and we have our center front. We'll go ahead and mark our zip allowance for the back block. So for the back block, I'm going to mark 2 inches for my zip allowance. I will go ahead and connect the lines together. Once I'm done with that, I will go ahead and mark my dart measurement, which is 4 inches, starting from my zip line. I'll connect the lines together. Now, on the waistline, I will go ahead and mark 1/2 inch on both sides. Because we are drafting the back block where we don't have our bust, I'm going to have like my basic darts for the back block, okay? The reason why we are doing that is because we don't want to achieve like a princess dart bustier at the back, because we don't have a bust at the back. So I'm going to leave the back like a basic dart, and white for the front, we'll have our princess dart bustier. So once we are done with that, we'll go ahead and mark our shoulder measurement. So after marking our shoulder measurement, we'll mark our bust measurement. We'll go ahead and mark our waist measurement. connect it together using our pattern master to connect our bust waist, and we'll use our armhole curve to connect our bust to our shoulder line. Kindly give this video a thumbs up, like, share, and subscribe. So this is what we have. I will go ahead and cut this out. After cutting it out, this is what we are going to have. I will go ahead and make my back block like a full back block so that we can also achieve our monostripe effect. Note that for the back block, you have to determine where you also want your monostripe to fall, and it all depends on the front block also, because if your monostripe falls at the right hand side, it must fall the same way in the front block so that you can have like a complete outfit. So use your front block to determine where your back block is going to fall, okay, so that your monostripe can fall at the same part of your arm. So this is what we have. Once you've done that, we've determined where our monostripe is going to fall, so we'll go ahead and mark our neckline. So we'll mark our neckline, which we have 3 inches. Now we'll start our measurement after our zip allowance, and for the deepness, I'll also make use of 5 inches, right? So I'll go ahead with my pattern master and connect the neckline / bust line, okay, so that we can have a slant. Ahead and cut this out. After cutting it out, this is what we are going to have. This is like our full back block. So we have our fabrics, which is available at our store and is available both in wholesale and in retail prices. Now for our back block, we are going to go ahead and open it up because we are going to fix in zip at the back. So we'll go ahead and open this up. Now place your back block on the fabric on a single fold. We are not folding the fabric into two because they don't have the same shape, right? So place each part on the fabric and then you go ahead and cut this out. You are going to have for the back block. So you have 2 pieces for the back block. By the time you are done fixing your zip, we have 1 piece. So for the front block also, we'll go ahead and place it on the fabric, and this is what we have when we cut it out. Now for the sides of our front block, we'll also cut it out separately because they are not the same, okay? So this is what we have for the front block. So we have our complete front block and you can see what it looks like. So for our pleating, now we are attaching pleating to our monostripe. We've gone ahead to measure 114 cm by the length, by the width, and by the length we have our measurement for the length, okay? Note that your monostripe can be a gown, that is a straight gown, or you can just attach pleating to it, or yours can be a top. It depends on how you want to rock your monostripe gown, okay, or your monostripe gown, right? So it could be a monostripe top, you can attach your pleating to it, or you can make it a straight gown. So the next thing we are going to do now is, this is what we have. You can see this beautiful fabric. So the next thing we are going to do now is to take our wording. We have the shiny parts and the smooth parts of our wording. Go ahead and iron the shiny parts to the fabric using a very hot steam press, and then you place each wording on each part of the front block, then you go ahead and stitch it. Now when you want to stitch your princess, that starts from the lower side all the way to the upper side, so you do the same for the other side. Once you are done with that, the next thing you are going to do now is to go ahead and cut your interface, known as your lining. Use it to turn your front block because you are going to have a single piece for your front block, okay? So for the back block now, we've gone ahead to turn our back block with lining, and then we just stitch our darts, like your basic darts. So this is what you have for the back block. So go ahead and fix in your zip. okay, at your back block, and you can see the shape of our monostripe coming out. So the next thing you are going to do now is to go ahead and couple the shoulders up. Use your measurement to join the sides together, and you can see our one shoulder effect. And so you can go ahead and attach your pleats to it, or you can make yours a monostripe top or a monostripe dress. Thanks so much for watching,